Hello and welcome to Our Year with the Ears, our daily vlog where we relive our year living in the Walt Disney World Resorts in 2019. Today is day 187.
We woke up here at Contemporary and once again had those amazing Gaston cinnamon rolls for breakfast. We still have the microwave in here, so we warmed them up. They were very good, but still almost to the point of like, I don't know if they're gonna last a lot longer anyway, so we finished those off. Today is also moving day. We are leaving Contemporary and heading over to Caribbean Beach. So we got everything packed up, called Bell Services, and they said, hey, it's gonna be a little while. Today's a Saturday, so it's very busy. We probably won't be up there for about an hour. This was about 10:30 and checkout is supposed to be at 11. So they told us to just let housekeeping know that we were waiting on them. So they did knock on the door around 11 o'clock. We said, we're waiting for Bell Services. We're so sorry. We hope they come soon, but it might be like another 30 minutes. They said that was totally fine. We're waiting on them. Sure enough, around 11:30, they did come and get all of our suitcases. We only kept what we can carry. We headed downstairs and Ubered over to Caribbean Beach so we could get checked in. When we got there, we got to see the amazingly long line they had. Mm-hmm. Again, it's a Saturday, that's understandable. We would love to do online check-in, however, that just doesn't work for us. So we did have to stand in this line, and we had to stand in that line for over an hour.
Somehow, whenever we check in at a moderate resort, it always seems to be a really long line. Mm-hmm. I don't know why we always happen to get the back end of a long line, but we do for whatever reason. Once we finally got up there, got checked in, our room wasn't quite ready yet. So we figured it was a good time to go and grab some lunch, went over to the Centertown Market, which is the quick service there at Caribbean Beach, and ordered a few different things because we wanted to try something different on the menu this time. Alyssa got the Cuban sandwich. I am not a fan because I don't like mustard or pickles, so not really my kind of sandwich, but she got it with some fruit and she really enjoyed the sandwich, said it was pretty
really
good.
I wouldn't
know because I didn't try it, but her sister got a small side of macaroni and cheese. That's all she wanted to eat, so we got that for her. And then I got the braised beef stew that was really more like a rice bowl because It wasn't your traditional beef stew. But oh my goodness, the flavors in this were so good. Great combined with the rice and beans, or great on its own with the beef there. I was really impressed with this because the last time we were here, we weren't so thrilled with their food court. But this time around, I feel like this dish has redeemed them just a little bit for us because it's really good.
And I actually ate a lot of his food too. I liked my sandwich until I tried his food, and then I really wanted that. Like, that was what I started craving. So I did save about half my sandwich for later because I really enjoyed his rice bowl.
After we finished eating, we started walking around the resort, just kind of looking around, seeing if anything's going on. Happened to see that they had a photo frame to take pictures with at the front, right there where you check in. So we took a picture with that, and right around that time, we got the text message that our room was ready. Now, we booked a water or pool view, so we didn't know where it was gonna be, which building it was gonna be, or whether it's facing the pool or facing the water. Turns out we got an amazing location. Mm-hmm. We were in the preferred section and we were not facing the pool, which is what we wanted because it tends to be a little louder by the pool and we try to stay away from that. We were facing the water and also facing the construction of Riviera. So it was really a pretty area that we were in. And because of the trees and everything, we actually had a really nice view and you couldn't even really tell there was construction going on in Riviera. So overall, we're really happy with the water view that we got. Of course, we went to the room and took pictures of all the details throughout the room and did 360 pictures. And then we did a room tour that we recorded so we could post it up on Facebook and YouTube later.
This particular room has two queen-size beds with, actually, I think these headboards are pretty cool. They kind of remind me of the ones at Animal Kingdom Lodge because they're made of wood, but they got this cool carving on it that very much reminds you of the Caribbean, which I thought that was a kind of a cool touch. And the bottom of the headboard here is like a, it looks kind of like shutters from an old storm shutters on a house or something. So I thought that was kind of cool. But we do have the two queen beds. And over here on the right side of the room, we also have a fifth sleeper, which is a pull down bed we'll show you here in just a second.
And if you'd like to see that tour, it's linked up there in the corner and down there in the description.
After we did our tour of the room, we decided to head to Animal Kingdom. Even though it was raining, that wasn't gonna deter us from going to the park. We were really excited because it's raining, which means I can wear my brand new Minnie Mouse poncho that I've been waiting to wear, and it is raining, and we're gonna go to the park, and we're gonna have fun, and I'm gonna wear my poncho and be so excited. So we hopped on the bus and headed over to Animal Kingdom. We were really impressed with how few people there were in the park. I guess because it's raining, everyone went back. but we used this time to go to the park and enjoy these shorter wait times. We headed over to Dinosaur and rode that a couple different times. The first time, my sister did not react at all to the dinosaur, which was hilarious. She's like, I don't want that picture, so what do we save? So we had to get back in line and ride again so that we got a different one. As we left Dinosaur, we noticed that they were still doing a meet and greet with Chip and Dale in their dinosaur costumes. There was no photo pass out because it is still raining, but they said if you want to take a picture with your phone, you can. And I was like, yes. There was no one in line. I don't think most people realized they were over there, and there were so few people in the park, they weren't really back in the dinosaur area. So I got in line and had to take some really fun pictures with Chip and Dale, and they were totally all for it. We did jumping in the air. They were so adorable. They gave me a hug. This was one of the best meet and greets ever. And then my sister took some pictures with them as well. And I just loved how much fun we had. We actually stayed with them a decent amount of time because there was no one waiting. So we were able to just chat with them and talk to them. They loved the colors of my shirt because it kind of matched them. It was just a really fun experience. And then after this, like I said, there weren't many people out. Not a lot was going on. It's raining. I'm wearing my Minnie Mouse poncho that I love so much. And so I had to do a poncho dance in the rain. And it was hilarious and ridiculous, and I can't dance, but it just shows how happy I was to have this poncho.
From there, we headed over to Kilimanjaro Safari because we figured, why not go ride it? It's a pretty slow day in the park. Mm-hmm. On the way over there, we found a hidden Mickey in the cracks in the concrete, which was pretty cool because I've never seen this one before. Kept going over, got in line at the safari, and it turns out, so did everyone else, because this actually has a line, unlike everything else in the park. So we waited in line for about 35 or 45 minutes to get on the safari. Finally got up there, got on the truck, and this safari was amazing. Mm-hmm. They had so many animals out because it was cooler because it was raining. So they all came out and were enjoying the nice weather. So we got to get some great pictures of some of the animals that you may not normally see out on the safari.
It was really amazing, even with the steady rain, to see the elephants out, the cheetahs were out. There were even Ankole cattle like right next to our Jeep, which was really cool. We had such an amazing experience. This was definitely worth the wait. After we got off the ride, we decided we were getting hungry now. We've been in the park for a few hours. So we made the decision to walk back across the park over to Restaurantosaurus for dinner, but we did have a good reason to do so. Poorly planned on our part, but we did have a good reason to go over there because there was a special 4th of July meal that Robert wanted to try. They're still doing it, so he wanted to try the special burger. I didn't necessarily care about it, but we're going for him. And this was the last day they were doing it. So we headed over there. My sister got chili cheese fries. I got the fried shrimp and chicken with fries combo basket, which was really good and really what I wanted.
And then I got the special 4th of July patriotic burger. I think they're going for firecracker or something with it. It was a 7-ounce burger with cheddar cheese and pulled pork on top. And it also had jalapeno poppers on top. And it was supposed to be served with fries and beer, but I just had them take my fries and make it into those chili cheese fries for her sister and told them I didn't need the drink. This burger was ridiculously tall when I tried to eat it because jalapeno poppers aren't exactly flat, but it had a lot of flavor between the pulled pork and the jalapeno poppers and the cheese and everything. Really good burger and a step up from what I expected to get at a quick service restaurant. I kind of thought it was going to be just the normal quick service burger with stuff thrown on top, but it was a big patty and it had a lot of flavor. I was a big fan of this burger.
After we finished up, we decided it's time to head back. We have enjoyed our time in the park. We weren't here to do everything, just to enjoy the ambiance and enjoy a few rides. So we started heading out and we realized that we had joined a parade when we were heading out, because it was a parade of ponchos. The entire park was covered in ponchos, everyone leaving. So we had the poncho parade on our way out of the park, and it was amazing. We headed out to the bus, and we did have to wait. There wasn't a bus out there. That's completely understandable. We expect that. But when the bus pulled up, I saw my shadow on the side of the bus and realized that my shadow looks like Winnie the Pooh when I wear this poncho, and I couldn't stop laughing at it. It was hilarious because it's Minnie Mouse. When you look at it, you know it's Minnie Mouse, but the shadow looks like Winnie the Pooh. The shadow does not look like Minnie Mouse at all. And I just kept laughing the whole ride home because I'm like, every time I see my shadow now, I'm just gonna think Winnie the Pooh as I walk through the park.
Once we got off the bus, we headed back to our room. We are completely drenched. We are kind of cold now because we were on the freezing cold bus, soaking wet. Always a great combination. So we went back to our room and decided we weren't gonna go anywhere else tonight. We're not gonna do anything else. We're just gonna chill here in the room and watch Psych, because we've been watching through the seasons of it with her sister, and she's leaving in just a few days, so we gotta watch a few more episodes before she leaves. So we just watched Psych for the rest of the night and kind of relaxed there in the room, and that was the end of our day today. So we'll see you tomorrow
for our Year with the Ears.